Delighted to say we've got a host of stars on the show tonight. One of those is Julian Dicks, former Liverpool star, of course. Delighted to say he's on the Skype phone with us now. Julian, a very good evening to you.
Good evening.
Hello, mate. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. It's great to have you here on Sports Tonight Live. Julian, from all your readings and all the talks that you must have had today since this news broke, as a former Liverpool player, how is it being greeted by those who are very close, like yourself, to Liverpool Football Club?
I think, to be perfectly honest, I think it's a bit premature. Obviously, winning the Carling Cup, finalists of the FA Cup. But as you said, at the end of the day, they want the Premiership. And for Liverpool to finish eighth is not good enough.
Tenth, I think they finished, didn't they?
Eighth.
I beg your pardon. Yeah. One below.
Only 14, right. Only three more wins than Bolton.
Yeah, Julian, right. The point is that Kenny Dalglish had a problem for Liverpool. That is that he's an icon. He's a hero. He's a huge figure. The shadowing spreads all over Anfield. What happens now?
For Liverpool or for Kenny?
For Kenny's relationship with Liverpool. What happens now? I mean, can he ever go back to the training ground? Can he go back to Anfield and sit in the director's box?
I don't think that'll ever change. Kenny's, he's an icon in Liverpool. Okay, he's been sacked, but I don't think the supporters will ever change their views of him because, I mean, he's an absolutely fantastic footballer and fantastic for Liverpool as a player.
Julian, can I just ask, do you not think this was just a romantic appointment which has just backfired?
Yeah, possibly, but until you give these people a chance, you never know. I mean, you could have set the world alight, but unfortunately it hasn't happened like that. Yeah, I understand it. Obviously, the fans wanted him because of the way he was when he was a player. So, I mean, you can go from both sets of views from that.
Julian, it's Leroy here, mate. How are you doing?
I'm fine, Leroy. How are you?
I'm very good, mate. I just wondered, mate, because they'd only won 6 games at Anfield. I had lots of ex-Liverpool players saying that they played really well at Anfield, but they were just a little bit unlucky. But I saw a lot of Liverpool games, and they didn't play well at all. What would the atmosphere have been like next season if that had continued?
It wouldn't have been good. Like I said, I was there and we finished 7th, and obviously the expectations of the Liverpool supporters are that they want the Premiership. Okay, ain't going to happen every season, but they want to be challenging for it, Leroy. I mean, that's their expectations there. Nothing apart from that is good enough. But like I said, I've watched quite a few games, and perfectly honest, the games haven't been good. I agree with you.
And Julia, I mean, people keep saying they've got to change their style to suit Andy Carroll, get wingers and cross the ball. And I thought, well, that is never going to happen at Liverpool. What are they saying? Is Andy Carroll the answer to Liverpool's problems?
No, to be perfectly honest with you, I like Andy Carroll. I think he's a good player. And I would have him in my side all day long. But you've got wingers there, like him, Downing and things like that. But they don't get enough crosses in the box. They play nice football at times. But the games I've watched, they seem to lump it up to Andy Carroll. He flicks it on. There's no one running on for him. So, that way of playing is dead in the water. But I agree. They have to get the ball wide and they have to get chances in the box for him.
Julian, I think it was would you agree that it was far-fetched and extreme to expect someone who had not managed in the Premier League for something like 13 years, I think since 1998, to come in and just pick up where he left off? I mean, I say pick up where he left off. He didn't do a very good job at Newcastle. Last time he did a decent job was at Blackburn. He left there in 1995. It's an awful long time ago, and the game is almost different, almost a completely different sport to what it is in 2012.
Well, it is. Of course it is. I mean, the game's moved on. But like I said, I think obviously the fans wanted him. And the thing is, the fans, they can either sack you or they stick by you, they can get you a job. I mean, they have a lot of influence to do with it. And I think, obviously, a lot of it was to get Kenny into the managing position.
Exactly as you say, because he's an icon. And that's what I'm talking about, really. The iconic status of Kenny Dalglish has surely got to be removed until Liverpool can move on. Julian, I want to thank you very much indeed for joining us tonight. Very good of you to take time out. It's a massive story, of course, and we really appreciate your input.
Stay ahead of the game with Sports Tonight Live. Don't miss a thing. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Search for Sports Tonight Live on Facebook and like our fan page. Follow Sports Tonight TV on Twitter and tweet us your thoughts and opinions. Sports Tonight Live, it's the platform for the fans.